1027 WNEW, the Rock of New York. Two for Tuesday, Nirvana, About a Girl from the Unplugged CD, and All Apologies, too. It's Opie and Anthony.
Hello.
Wow, what a day for a Hummer.
My God, huh?
Ah, my headphones are crapping out.
So did mine.
Really?
Yeah, what's up with that? Hello.
Well,
there we go.
They're setting up for Collective Soul. They're stopping by for a little visit today. Can't wait to see those guys.
Mm-hmm.
We've been following those guys for three radio stations now. It's pretty weird.
Yeah. Looking forward to hearing them.
So, all right. Well, you want to start with some instant feedback?
What do we got?
Gene from College Point. Very excited that today is Hummer Tuesday.
Mm-hmm.
My husband Charlie and I are married 14 years today, and we are both longtime fans of WNEW and new fans of Opie and Anthony.
All right.
I was wondering if you could let him know that my anniversary present to him is to induct him into the Tuesday Hummer Club.
Ugh.
Oh, my headphones crapped out again.
Yeah.
You too?
Now they're back.
Do they crap out there, though?
Yeah, they are. Something's weird.
They're plugging in stuff outside the studio, and I think that's screwing us up a little bit.
Yeah. Oh, I hate that.
Where was I?
Present.
Oh, yeah. Let him know that my anniversary present to him is to induct him into the Tuesday Hummer Club tonight. Nobody deserves it more than he does. Thanks, and keep up the good work. Charlie, you got a present tonight, brother.
Rush home.
Mm-hmm.
Man, that's something.
Well, we got to get this out of the way right away. We haven't played this one in a couple weeks.
What do you got?
Well, just to get everyone in the mood for today.
It's Hummer time, Hummer time, hum hum, Hummer time, 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 Hummer time.
There you go. Oh, man, it crapped out again.
Yeah, mine are doing the same thing.
Really?
Yeah.
We can't do a radio show this way.
I hear it going in and out.
To you at home, it doesn't make sense because you're hearing our voices, but...
Is it back now?
Oh, no, it crapped out again.
Now it's out.
Hello? Ah.
That's... I don't know if...
This is going to be very annoying.
If it has anything to do with your connection.
You think?
I don't know.
I didn't do anything there.
Yeah. All right. Here we go. Engineer.
Here's Pete. He's got to do a job here.
What seems to be the problem?
Ah.
Yeah.
It's crapping out on us, Pete.
What about this?
Will that work?
What do you hear?
I hear our voices better in our headphones.
But we also heard it good before, and then it would crap out.
Well, let's see if this works.
Okay.
Now I'm so distracted what we were going to talk about.
Yeah, I know.
All right. Well, we got to congratulate University of Connecticut. Wow. March Madness is finally over.
So they won.
They won, yes. It was a great game last night.
I was really paying attention, close attention to it, and I seem to have missed that.
Well, I was hoping you were going to give me some credit today, Anthony.
I'll give you some credit. Go ahead, LB.
Well, when the tournament started, what did I tell you?
You said...
That Connecticut would play Duke in the finals.
Yes, you did.
But I did say that Duke would win.
That you did.
But that's pretty damn close.
Well, I don't know. Is it close? How many teams are in it?
A lot. 64.
That's very good. To pick the final game,
that's not too shabby.
I was a little tired of March Madness, to be quite honest with you.
Really?
Yeah, well, every commercial's got to, you know, McDonald's March Madness. You know, everyone hops on the bandwagon. I don't think, I mean, obviously it's very popular, but I think there's a lot of people that don't know or care what it is.
I don't know. I think more people were following March Madness than the stupid NBA, obviously, you know?
You think so?
Really?
All right.
Yeah, March Madness is huge, eh? I'm just not a hoops fan. That's okay.
I am not. I'm sorry.
And we're hearing from all the Ranger fans today. Shut up. Everyone knows we're Islander fans. You're an Islander fan, too, right?
It's very hard to say yes, but yes.
Yeah. Just remember, in 1999, Opie and Anthony admitted they were Islander fans on the radio.
Yeah.
So in 10 years, when the Islanders are good again, we could say that we didn't jump on the bandwagon.
Right. 10 years.
It could take a while.
I know.
But the Rangers swept the season series. So
yeah.
All right.
Woo. Now we got to regroup.
Yeah,
our headphone debacle.
The headphones are driving us nuts. It doesn't sound the same in the phones.
I think your volume, maybe. I had to turn mine down a little.
No, I don't know. All right. Sorry, guys. We'll try to figure this out next. Yeah. Honestly, I think there's a problem with this microphone.
With the mic?
Yeah, it's not picking up. I don't know. We'll have Pete take a look when
we take a break here, okay? All right.
Two for Tuesday continues. Judas Priest on the way. If you want to hear something, 212-757-1027. You can send the faxes in, 212-957-WNEW. And we have the instant feedback for you as well. Just go to the WNEW website, click on our pictures, and this is the button that has to be down.
Let me see.
This button right here.
What? No, no.
Now it's cutting out. Damn it. All right. Look. Ah, it's crapping out again. All right. Let's. Ah.
Hold on.
Every time I talk, my headphones crap out. That's what is going on here. 1027 WNEW, the Rock of New York. It's Opie and Anthony. We're blowing out some of the Tuesday Hummer songs because we got some technical problems in the studio here. Your headphones working?
Is this working? No.
It's not right?
Not working.
Oh, this is so annoying.
It cuts out. It gates out,
it sounds like.
Yeah, when we start talking, it clips out and then comes back on.
See, to the listener, they're just hearing our voices and they think there's no problem here, but yeah. I don't even think we could get phone calls on the air. Let's see.
We won't hear them.
Hi, NEW.
Hi.
No, we can't do phones yet. Sorry. Really can't do a radio show yet.
What happened between yesterday and today?
I don't know.
That did this.
I got to take my headphones off.
Yeah, we can't.
I'm
going to
throw them through a window.
Why don't you press the button with the processing?
What do you mean, this?
Yeah. Does that work?
Like that?
That other one? Yeah. Yeah, see? At least there you can, hear stuff.
All right, let's see if we can take the phone calls now. Hi, NEW.
Hello?
Yeah, what's up?
Hey, I was just calling to see if you saw my Tory sign yesterday at Raw.
Where were you seated?
I was about 15 rows up from the folding chairs.
No, we didn't see it.
Ah.
What did it say?
Tory, show us your balloon nut.
That's pretty good.
I sent you a feedback yesterday. You didn't get it?
No, we read it on the air.
Uh-huh.
So you definitely went through with it and did it, huh?
Yeah, I have the sign here.
Very cool. We're talking about wrestling last night at the Continental Arena, Raw is War.
Hmm.
And there you have it.
No, we didn't see that one. There's a lot of other funny signs, but not that one.
The best sign on TV last night was, is my sign on TV? That's what the guy's sign said. So, all right, man.
All right, thanks a lot.
Yeah, we got some technical problems in the studio, so we're a little distracted.
Yeah, all right.
All right, brother. Thanks.
Bye.
Damn.
All right, well, they're trying to figure it out.
These phones like this.
Ugh. All right.
Are we ever going to get through the show?
I don't know.
This is odd.
It's very distracting. Like, I definitely need this button now.
But then the headphones cut out. I just heard delay coming through.
Oh, it's a mess.
It's a mess in here. What happened? Did somebody do something from yesterday till today? What was done?
Ant, every other word is cutting out.
I know. What was done in here?
No big deal. It's not a big deal to have the equipment working when we're on the air.
But something changed from yesterday, right?
Yeah.
Till today.
Right.
I don't know what it was.
See, we sound like a-holes because to the listener, it sounds fine.
Yeah.
They don't get what the problem is.
Doesn't sound fine because we're talking kind of weird.
Yeah.
And we stop talking when it clips out in our ears.
Mm-hmm.
All right, it's not clipping now.
No, this may be it. We may be back in business here, Anthony.
All right.
Okay.
I hope so.
Jesus. The Rock of New York, 1027 WNEW, 2 for Tuesday with Ozzy Osbourne, Shot in the Dark and Crazy Train. You're hanging with Opie and Anthony.
Hey.
We sound annoyed, we are. All right, I just got to remember to keep our mic volume down, Anthony.
You never had to do that before.
No, see, if it's up here, it's going to crap out on us.
Yes.
But if it's down here, we'll be okay.
Well, now I got to turn my headphones up.
Yeah. All right.
Okay, we're good.
Yes.
Let's roll.
Okay. All right, Alan from Long Island on the instant feedback. Well, guys, I know it's Tuesday, but can I give a big FU to the IRS? And by the way, any day is a good day to say FU to the IRS. Did my taxes last night, and boy, is Uncle Sam bending me over, and without a Hummer. I hope they have payment plans. Otherwise, you can send me a greeting card and address it to Sing Sing Prison.
Oh.
Take care, guys.
Oh.
Don't get fired. New York needs you guys. Alan.
Yeah, tax time. Well, good luck to you, people. Good luck to you.
I was dealing with that a little bit today.
Yeah?
Benny taking care of me.
We love Benny.
Yeah.
Good guy.
I hope he can, you know, save me some of my hard-earned money.
Well, they do take a lot of tax out throughout the year, and then you find at the end of the year you have to pay above and beyond that.
And no one questions this?
No. No one questions it, Opie.
I mean, you look at your paycheck every 2 weeks, and you go, wow, they are taking a lot of money out.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're like, all right, at least I'll get some money back at the end of the year.
Wrong.
And you do your taxes and go, what? I still owe a couple thousand?
You owe.
How does that work?
Isn't that great? And then the money you get to keep, whatever you buy gets taxed. It's like, wait a minute. Wasn't I taxed on that already?
Yeah.
Like, I paid my tax. You were kind enough, out of the kindness of your heart, to let me keep some of this money. Thank you. So now when I go to spend it, I have to pay a sales tax.
Yes.
Well, that doesn't seem very fair, does it?
No, not at all.
What's the story with that? Okay, well, I'll put it in maybe some stocks or the bank account, whatever, and try to make some interest on it.
Sure.
That way, maybe I could gain back some of the money they took in taxes.
Right.
Okay, look, I made some money with my money.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they tax it. And they tax it a lot because that's special money.
Yeah.
I don't understand it.
You can't win.
You are penalized for achieving or trying to achieve the American dream.
Yeah. Supposedly we're making okay money now. Nothing great.
Mm.
But I don't know where the money is
that
I'm supposedly making. I still don't have a bank account, and I owe money this year again.
The bank is the dollar bills rolled up in my pocket. Far cabbage. But they just it keep taxing you.
Yeah.
Oh.
And no one questions it. We just go along and we'll pay it.
A few people question it in Montana with guns holed up in a house somewhere, you know?
Yeah.
They usually...
It's extortion.
Yeah, you're paying protection money to the government.
Where's the Soprano dude? We could use his help.
Tony Soprano. Mm. God, I love that show. Oh.
I'm really ticked off that I didn't jump on board the Soprano show.
They're going to rerun all the episodes on HBO?
Starting when? Because I got to see it from the beginning now.
Mm. Yeah, we have it written down somewhere.
All right.
But, you got to see the whole thing. The season finale's coming up. And, boy, it's a great show. And some of these Italian-American groups are all pissed off that it's portraying Italians as gangsters in a bad light. How come you can't portray a certain group as having an element in it that is bad? You're not saying everyone is. Like, when I watch The Sopranos, I'm not like, oh, boy, every Italian is in the mob. But there were some Italians in the mob.
Yeah.
Just the way it happened.
They pretty much started it.
Yeah, you know, coming out, what are you going to do? That's just the way it was. So if you want to portray one of them on TV, on HBO, and The Sopranos, well, who's to get pissed off? Who cares? It's part of history.
It's all part about getting politically correct in this country, Anthony.
People don't like things, even if they're true. Just cover them up, make like they never happened or don't happen, and the world will be a wonderful place.
Let's not acknowledge our history.
Yeah.
Let's just start like history today. That's what a lot of groups want. They want that.
Right.
Don't acknowledge what happened years ago. My God.
No. It's ridiculous, man. Gets me. Even my mom was in the mob.
Your mom?
My mom was in the mob.
Wait, hold on. Yeah. Dude, hold on. I got to get to this story. You still there?
Yeah.
All right, hold on. Your mom was in the mob?
Yeah. Back in the 40s. She was in the mob.
Explain.
She told me when we got together this weekend and told me how my grandfather was running numbers in Harlem back in the 40s, and she was a little kid, and he used to go, Baba, Baba, come walk with Daddy, come walk with Daddy. And as they were walking, he would put a big roll of paper down her sock. and then, you know, walk her somewhere. No. I was laughing. She's like a little girl, you know, but I'm laughing. Going, oh, you were in the mob? She's like, oh, scratch your ass. I wasn't in the mob.
She was a runner.
Yeah. She was like running numbers with my grandfather.
Wow. Was he heavy duty into it, or was he just kind of
I think he was just a
fringe player.
Yeah. I think the bottom line is back in the 40s in Harlem, in a lot of parts of New York, if you were Italian, a good way to make money was to hook up. You're not whacking people or anything, but a good way to make a little money was to run some numbers or work for some of the boys.
Uh-huh.
What are you going to do? Go and work at a trade or something and make half the money?
Well, at least this makes sense now. Because I was at your brother's wedding.
Yeah.
A year and a half ago now, when Joe got married.
Yeah.
I swear to God, I thought I was going to get whacked
in
there.
Stop it.
What do you mean, stop it?
There's no one in the mob in my family.
It was like the scene from the first Godfather. Who are you kidding?
There's no one in the mob in my family now. We're talking back in the 40s.
Well, it sure felt like it. How did Joe afford that wedding?
I don't know. He does things. He works.
That was probably the best wedding I've ever been at.
Wasn't that a good wedding?
It was great.
Yeah. No, none of my family.
I stood out like a sore thumb at that wedding, too.
My mother's telling me about my uncle Jakey, who was a second-story man. I mean, she got a few in her. She was spilling the beans. I think I have to whack my mom. It was pretty interesting.
And what is a second-story man for the people that don't know it?
You kind of, it's like a burglary guy. And he would make the things fall off the trucks.
Yeah,
he was into like hijacking and stuff. Because then my mother's like, oh yeah, we remember being kids and the truck would pull up in front of the house and we'd get TVs and clothes and dresses and all kinds of stuff off the truck. And she was very popular in the neighborhood because her father, my grandfather, would buy all the kids ice cream on the street. The ice cream man would come and he would set up all the kids.
It was only 5 cents back then.
Well, that's big money back then.
All right.
For all the kids. And forget about it. Yeah. Back in the old days. Harlem of the 40s.
The more and more I hang out with you, the more and more I learn. It's amazing.
That's right. Keep learning. Maybe someday I'll do you a favor.
All right. Hello.
Hey, how you doing?
What's up, buddy?
You guys are up and running again.
Sort of. The mic is, the headphones are still crapping out, but no one wants to hear us complain, so we're going to try to move on here.
All right. Well, I'm just sitting here sick. I'm trying not to laugh too hard or else I'll start coughing, but just want to say hey. So, see you later. This is your audience today.
Great, thanks.
All right.
Sick people complaining.
All right, buddy.
All right, man. All right. Bye.
I know what happened there. The actual guy hung up, and right when you hit the button, that guy got through on the line.
That's why we try to screen him a little bit. Hi, NEW.
Hey, guys, I got a great idea to do with all your money.
What?
Let's make a World War II movie with no Germans and no Japanese.
Yeah, that'll be the politically correct one.
Exactly. We won't offend anybody. We can make them like Martians or Planet of the Apes, and
then we talk it over. We don't drop any big bombs or anything.
No, of course not.
We just hash it out by talking, and then we save a whale and roll the credits. I like it. I like the way you think.
Yeah,
I'll send you the script.
That's pretty much what is going on in this world these days.
You can't acknowledge things that actually happened in this world as being accurate. The facts now are getting twisted. We're getting what they call revisionist history, Opie.
Mm-hmm.
People like remembering things different from the way they actually were. It's a sad thing. I don't care. I'm Italian, and I know that back in especially the 40s and the 50s, Italians ran organized crime. In the big cities, they did. That's just the way it was. And if you make a movie about it, why not give the guy Italian names? Because that's the way it was.
You're not going to give him an Irish name.
Well, there were some Irish mobs, too.
Not like the Italian mobs.
Not as fun. Well, Opie, they were always drunk. See, I'm being extreme here, folks. Don't you get it?
Well, we'll get a letter for that.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Hi, NEW.
Yeah, hello. I heard you guys talking about Italians, right?
Yeah, Dan, what's up?
Yeah, hi. A while ago, when immigrants first came to America, if some guy was brought to jail, 4 out of 5 chance it was an Italian.
Really?
4 out of 5, man.
Where are you getting your facts from?
Crimelibrary.com.
I love the internet now. You can just punch everything up.
I find stuff on Charles Manson, the Purple Gang, Jeffrey Dahmer.
Yeah.
And the guy that they modeled Dr. Hannibal from in Silence of the Lambs.
Yeah, Hannibal Lecter.
Well, at least you're using the internet for something useful.
I love the internet.
You got sick of the porno, huh?
No, I still do that.
Of course you do.
I'm not going to review it.
All right, man. We got to go.
Okay, bye-bye.
Isn't that amazing, though? A lot of people are learning a lot more things these days because it's right at your fingertips.
Yeah. Hi, Eddie W.
Yeah.
Hi.
What's up?
Hey.
You guys want to do the Godfather trivia?
Why? What do you got?
I got a lot of questions. I'm sure I'm going to stump them.
All right. How about one question?
All right. One question. I'll make it an easy one.
All right.
When, you know, in the first, what do you want from part one, part two?
One.
A one, yeah.
All right. When Paulie gets killed, you remember the driver? Paulie?
Yeah.
All right. When he gets killed, when Clemenza's out taking a leak?
Yeah.
What monument in the background?
What monument is in the background? Oh, is it the Robert Moses?
No, it's Statue of Liberty.
I don't know.
That was the
I got a lot of detail-oriented questions.
Yeah, I don't like those.
All right, well, why? Cause, yeah, you got these are the ones that you got to be paying attention.
Yeah, that's
but
like
I got all the ones too. But you know, I even wrote them down.
All right, one more.
All right. Yeah, you want another background question?
No, we don't. Background? Who cares?
A good one though.
All right, go ahead. A background. Dude, you can't curse.
Oh, sorry. I didn't realize I was on the air.
What is?
I'm sorry.
Everything's on the air.
Oh, my God.
I called one other time and you screened it. You played like 20 minutes before.
All right, listen.
Oh, sorry.
All right, give us your other Godfather question without cursing.
All right, are we doing it for prizes, though?
Oh.
Goodbye. There's your trivia. Goodbye. And the answer is, hang up on you.
What took us so long? We should have hung up on
you
30 seconds ago.
Background question.
All right, we have Collective Soul coming in the studio. When? Like 5 o'clock or so? They're playing the Bowery Ballroom. We'll get you warmed up. The Rock of New York, 1027 WNEW, 2 for Tuesday. Collective Soul Heavy off their Dosage CD and Where the River Flows. Those guys playing the Bowery Ballroom tonight for a little visit. Should be here by 5 o'clock. I think we're going to try to talk him into playing.
Yeah. They better play.
Well, they've been here 3 or 4 times now. Now I think it's time for them to play a few songs for us.
Pick up your instruments.
I think we can
play.
Hopefully make that happen. Why is the boss guarding the door?
Yeah, look at that. He's leaning against it.
I think he wants
Ali.
No, he wants to be on the radio today.
You want to come on?
I just feel it.
You don't need any more vagary on this show.
Oh, he was upset with us yesterday talking about how vague he is. Like when we ask him about things, rumors in the paper you might have read, and we ask for him to clear things up, and he's a little upset. I said he's very green-spanny.
Yeah.
Well, I always say no.
No, you don't.
Are we going to K-Rock?
No.
Okay.
You're being evasive.
Well, that was in the paper.
You're being evasive.
That's what Opie said. You're being evasive. Why don't you tell me the truth? I said no.
Well, it was reported in the paper yesterday we're going to K-Rock to do mornings.
Yeah. I think that slot's taken.
Yeah, I think so. And he's
by somebody pulling in a lot of cake for the station.
I believe he does a good job at it, too.
Yeah, yeah. I think he's got a few listeners.
Man,
Jesus.
What is wrong with the radio reporters in this town?
Well, that was Peter Goodman.
They're on dope or something.
Peter Goodman. I think maybe years of toupee glue.
Well, you know what?
Was that
Peter
it?
Goodman started the whole rumor about a month ago.
Yeah, he starts it. And then
now he's writing on it. It's
and then
a
he reports about the rumor that... That's brilliant.
So when all these rumors don't come true, or most of them, I hope...
No, you can't say that, because sometimes a rumor gets out there, and it gets around enough that the people who make the decisions actually go, man, that's a pretty good idea, we should do that.
Yeah. Oh, look at that.
Sometimes that happens.
But we're going to call Pete out on this one.
Yeah.
When we finally settle the dust around here.
Yeah.
And then we're going to read all his columns on the air to show people how wrong he was.
He thought we were going homo urban.
Well, then there's a rumor that we're going country.
Whew.
That's making the internet these days.
Ouch! I'll tell you true, this is true, though. Garth Brooks' manager called Scott Herman and said if we went country that Garth would come for a month for free and do a show.
Oh, who cares? Garth.
Garth.
Is he still hitting baseballs?
Apparently that's not working out.
Well,
I would
obviously.
Hope so.
Ugh. Why does
I got friends. Get out of here.
Yeah. Why does he get a chance to make a baseball team, and you and I, we don't? Well, this is it because he's famous?
Justin, we're going country Spanish talk. That's what we're doing. It's talk about Spanish country music.
Yeah, we'll cover all our bases.
I think they do that in Los Angeles now.
So you can confirm we're not going to K-Rock to do mornings. We're staying right here.
Right.
We're not getting fired.
Correct. Well, I don't know.
Depending on... That's up to
that's
us.
That's a separate issue.
But everything we've done thus far will not get us fired, right?
Yeah.
Okay. What about the alt talk?
What are you doing now?
See, that's what we mean by
See,
vague.
He's very vague.
Right there.
But you
that's
can talk
a little,
if you want.
Little thing.
All right.
Yeah.
I don't mind if you go all talk.
So he's very vague about the talk issue.
We go all talk.
Okay.
Well, what else matters outside of you?
See, this is what we mean. Remember the episodes of Kung Fu? Remember yeah. Kung Fu, like, all of a sudden, when he was in the monastery thing, mm-hmm. he would walk up to the head guy there and ask him a question, and the guy would go, "No, grasshopper, you will know when the time is right. You will..." I would turn around and go, "Look, just tell me."
Yeah.
You know, I need to go to this place and save somebody.
Sure.
So when do I make my move? You will know when it is right. Tell me.
Well, Gary,
take the mystery out of it.
Well, Gary did shave his head, so.
Yes. Ah.
No, it fell out.
That'll happen around here.
All right.
Okay.
Well, thanks for just clearing up so many things.
He also was talking to us about our website.
Yeah.
He was meeting with the lawyers today.
That's interesting.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, apparently there's a real difference between indecency and obscenity.
Indecency and obscenity.
Yeah.
Now, what's bad?
Well, the difference basically, as I understood it, because it was a lot of lingo.
A little vague.
But basically the...
Get used to it.
It becomes obscene when it produces a kind of a
stimulating
response. Right.
When it stimulates.
Right. It stimulates the... Right.
Right.
But some people are stimulated by... girls in bikinis, and that can be in an ad in a JC.
Bird watching.
Yeah, yeah,
some people
right.
are getting stimulated just looking at the pictures of the jocks on the NEW website. So who's going to define that?
We can't find that person at this point.
And does the web fall under that jurisdiction?
Well, not yet.
Yeah.
But the courts are now beginning to look into that.
Oh, it's going to be a long, arduous battle. I think we will emerge victorious as perverts.
Yeah.
That seems to be...
You know what it is? The web, you can't control where everything's coming from. I love these lawmakers. We're saying no gambling. No internet gambling. How are you going to plug up the phone lines from an island off of Greece or something, you know? It can't be done. This is finally a medium that really they have a hard time controlling.
Well, the government will figure out something, though. They always do. They always do.
All right. You know, we'll see. I don't know.
The biggest issue is taxes. Like,
yeah.
If there's going to be commerce, and there's how are they going to get
cash?
Revenue? Right.
That's what they
the
want.
Governments want revenue.
Their money.
Right.
Because right. people are making money hand over fist on the net.
Yeah.
And they're not getting their piece.
So the higher-ups, they have a problem with the website, or they're a little scared.
No, everybody's into it.
Maybe yeah.
We have lots of people that volunteered to research this whole
You know thing. We're getting about 50,000 hits a day right now from those pictures from Friday?
Wow.
They're just... preemptive, you know, they want to look at it and make sure, you know, you waterproof your basement hoping it never floods, but you know, you want it there just in case.
Now, was that green spanny or what? What was that?
You did pretty well there.
I know the lawyers around here.
We don't want to
they're taking care of us.
We don't want to get kicked off an eighth server.
No, I don't think that'll happen.
No,
hopefully.
So if it's stimulating.
Well, there's some stimulating pictures on there.
What if it's repulsive?
Hmm. Yeah, there's some repulsive stuff on there.
Yeah.
Well, that's the other thing. I mean, some people find all sorts of things repulsive, and other people find them stimulating.
Right.
Yeah. See, they're trying to fit everything into categories when people, in general, have different views on everything.
Right.
You can't have one guy saying this is acceptable and this isn't, because the next guy thinks it's the other way around. I don't know. I'm for opening everything up.
Yeah.
I like everything.
Hey, did you talk to Priceline today? Can we bust
Haven't
that on the air?
I haven't heard from them, but as soon as we do, yeah, that'll be good.
All right. It's not confirmed, but You know, we talked to Tara yesterday, hottest girl to ever pose naked on the Opie and Anthony show.
Mm-hmm.
And she wanted a little class brought into this contest that we've started 3 months ago.
She was a little upset. It was getting a little sleazy for her.
A little sleazy on Friday. We understand that.
We told her that the four girls that came in, one of which will challenge her, that was a preliminary bout.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's in the back room at the stinky gym.
Yeah.
They have to work their way up to the big time.
Well, we're cleaning it up, and the person that takes on Tara from those four girls that everyone's voting on, go to the semi-live studio cam in the Opie and Anthony section of the NEW website if you haven't cast your vote yet. The winner of that competition, when we pick the girl to take on Tara, will win a trip from Priceline.com.
How about that?
Not confirmed yet, but pretty close.
Yeah, we were talking to him.
So we're cleaning up this contest and making it worthwhile.
Isn't that fantastic? Priceline, I told you, they're great. I love them.
So that'll bring some more women out of the woodworks.
Yeah.
All right?
All right. Well, thank you for clearing all that up, boss.
Anytime.
What did he clear up?
I don't know. Well, I guess we're not going to K-Rock, and we're going to be dumped from an eighth server.
Oh, great.
I'm going to get some Jell-O for you now.
Okay. I could use it for that.
You're getting a little slow there.
Ooh, look at that. He's taking a jab at you.
Ouch. That hurts. Go do some work.
The Rock of New York, 1027 WNEW, 2 for Tuesday. Kiss calling Dr. Love in Detroit, Rock City.
Music sounds good today, man. We're rocking.
Yeah.
It's Opie and Anthony. Don't forget, coming up around 5 o'clock, we got Collective Soul for a little visit tonight. They're playing the Bowery Ballroom. And lots of instant feedback coming in. We were talking about how politically correct the world's getting. I think it's obvious to everyone by now.
Mm-hmm.
And how we want to pretty much forget about history and make believe it never happened.
Well, anytime you portray it on television or whatever medium you choose, people will come out of the woodworks and yell and bitch that a certain ethnic group or nationality is being portrayed in a bad light.
Correct.
When, in the meantime, that's the way history was. So when an Italian is portrayed as a gangster on television.
Sopranos,
yeah, was getting all kinds of flack from Italian groups. I love the show. And it, you know something? There were a few Italian people in the mob.
Ooh, did I say that? Ooh, Opie, ooh. Can you imagine if they made The Godfather? In this day and age,
yeah,
it wouldn't be the same movie.
I know.
It would probably blow.
People get very upset.
But I think we touched a nerve because Larry from the island writes, watching a John Wayne movie the other day on A&E, and they censored the word Jap.
Huh. Are you kidding?
They didn't bleep it, just deleted it. You saw John Wayne's lips move, and you could tell what he said, but no sound.
You censored the Duke? They censored the Duke?
You can't censor the Duke.
Especially when he's saying Jap. My God. Did he say Jerry? Talking about the Germans? Maybe Nip?
That's what they were called when we were fighting them.
That's what it was. We weren't very friendly with each other.
No, they were the enemy.
No. We weren't going over there and trading recipes.
No.
I think we were bombing each other. Oh, people.
So there's plenty of those type of examples, I'm sure. If you got one, you could definitely get a hold of us.
Get a grip.
Well, we found the William Shatner song, Anthony.
Really?
Yeah.
Good. I like this.
Which one do you want to hear? We got a couple of them. We got Mr. Tambourine Man.
That's a favorite.
We have Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds.
I love Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds. He is so dramatic in this. He is he is hamming it up. This was done when? In the 70s? Like very early 70s or maybe late 60s?
Yeah, somewhere in the 70s. Now, did he do this as a goof or were they serious when they were putting these songs out?
From everything I've read and I've heard him talk about this, he was doing his interpretation of the music. So he was serious doing this. He's not a singer. He is an actor, right. A thespian.
Yeah.
So he was acting
the song.
The song in lieu of singing it.
Okay.
So it's Bill Shatner. What an actor anyway. And then when he acts a song, you bring tears to your eyes.
This is top shelf stuff, Anthony.
Oh, my God.
Would you like to hear Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds by William Shatner?
I love this.
This is not Anthony. This is an actual...
No, this is really William Shatner. He did this. Yeah, great music. See him in the studio, you know?
Sounds like a Christmas song.
Yeah.
The intro?
Captain's Log.
Lucy in the
Yeah. Studio musician chicks. He was probably at the mixing board making sure everything's okay.
Turn it down a bit. Just turn it down a bit.
Here he comes.
Picture yourself in a boat on a river with tangerine trees and marmalade skies. Somebody calls you. You answer quite slowly. A girl. With kaleidoscope eyes.
Oh, my God.
Cellophane flowers.
Hey, you.
Of yellow and green towering over your head. Look for the girl with a sun in her eyes. And she's gone.
Nice effect. Wow.
How did I do? Did I hit that last note properly?
Yes, you did, Mr. Shatner.
I like the echo effect. Instead of going off into space, the final frontier.
All right, here he comes.
Follow her down to a bridge by a fountain where rocking horse people eat marshmallow pies. Everyone smiles as you drift past the flowers that grow so incredibly high. Newspaper taxis appear on the shore, waiting to take you away. Climb to the back with your head in the clouds, and you're gone!
Yeah, Bill. Oh, wow. Does he kick ass or what?
Yeah. And you're gone, gone, gone.
All right, here he comes again.
Picture yourself on a train station with plasticine porters with looking glass ties. Suddenly, someone is there at the turnstile. A girl with kaleidoscope eyes.
Oh, is he great? My hero.
In the sky.
The big fade out here.
Wow.
There he is.
Is that brilliant? See, the last verse, he's not as, just up on the whole thing, you know?
Incredibly high. He's like,
picture yourself, train, station. Something happened in between.
I think the pot wore
that
off.
Got him. Maybe that was, you know.
Also, Spock singing, I Have a Hammer, or If I Had a Hammer, is a good one.
I believe we got that.
Do we?
Yeah. We could screw around with these songs today.
William Shatner. God, that is just a brilliant interpretation, Bill.
You can't even come up with a better bit than that.
No.
And it's real. William Shatner should do another album, Metallica songs.
Ooh. Hey, maybe we could do that.
That could be cool.
The Rock of New York, 1027 WNEW, 2 for Tuesday with Pink Floyd. It's Opie and Anthony. Got a guy on the line that, what is his name, Mike? He runs a Star Trek club, and he never heard that William Shatner song we just played a little while.
Really?
Mike. Hey, Mike.
What's up?
Did you like that William Shatner song?
Guy, that was... been trying to find it just so I can, you know, play it over and over and to annoy everybody else that I know.
Is that the funniest thing?
Hysterical.
Yeah, pretty funny.
Yeah, but you run a William Shatner club?
No, a Star Trek fan club.
All right, Star Trek fan club, and you don't have a copy of that?
You know how much these dealers are asking for something like that?
That's dealers. But that, you can find that pretty much anywhere on the internet. It's, what was it, part of Golden Throats or something like
that?
Yeah. It's an album that's available.
They just had a convention in the city this past week, and it wasn't there.
Mm. Oh, you went?
Oh, yeah. I do security at the conventions.
Do you get all dressed up?
Sometimes.
As a security officer?
Hold on a second, guys.
I don't know if he does security, but he dresses up like a...
Sorry about that.
Dress up like the Enterprise security?
Oh, hell no. We got our own uniforms.
Oh, Klingon.
Not exactly. We got our friends dressing up as Klingons. We do our own uniforms. I'm sure you guys are familiar with the Imperial Universe. The ones where they play bad guys.
Oh, yes, of course.
Yeah, that's the way we dress up.
Ah.
We got our own uniforms. Uniforms aren't standard. We got levy uniforms.
Hey, can you pick up chicks at these conventions?
Oh, please. Why would you want to do that?
I don't know.
Well, could you pick up guys? I mean, what do you mean? Why would I want to do that?
Man, these are the bunch of biggest weirdos around. I mean, hey, I may like the stuff, but some of these people are more far out than I am.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's the strangest thing you've seen at a Star Trek convention?
I'm sorry?
What is the strangest thing you've seen at a Star Trek convention?
Oh, man. I don't know. I've just seen so many different things.
Yeah.
The people in costumes. Right. Let's put it this way. Sometimes that much flesh should not be allowed to fit in so much leather.
Really?
Yeah.
I've seen some of the fat girls that try to dress up like some of the chicks Kirk has scored with.
Hold on, guys. I'm at work. I got to answer a call.
All right, we got to let you fly then, man.
Okay.
We can't wait for your little call there.
Okay.
All right, man. That's all right.
WNEW New York, Infinity Broadcasting.
All right, Anthony, MapQuest.com.
No need to get lost ever again. Ever again. You're going to be going out somewhere? You have a destination you don't know how to get to? Put it in MapQuest.com.
This really is a great idea. I wish I came up with it. I'd be a billionaire.
Well, you were too busy with pornography on the computer to think of something as useful as this.
You know, I've been doing the internet thing for almost 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
And if I would have spent more time trying to figure out a way to make money with the internet instead of checking out all the porn sites, you're right.
Let's look back in time. Here's the people at MapQuest at a little get-together in front of their computer. Guys, we can do something where people put the destination of the place they want to go in the computer and put in where they're leaving from. And we will print out detailed directions to the destination with mileage and where you make your turns and a color map of the entire area so people will not get lost. This is what the internet is about. And it's free. Totally free.
Correct.
This will help people.
Now that's,
so they don't get lost.
Now, that's what they were doing. What were you doing?
And they made it work.
Yeah, what were you doing while they were coming up with that idea?
Well, both of us.
I know.
In front of the computer.
So pathetic.
Okay, download that JPEG. Oh, look at the cans on her. Is that beautiful? Okay, MapQuest, helping people not get lost. Free service.
Mm-hmm.
Directions.
Mm-hmm.
Maps.
Mm-hmm.
It's brilliant. A brilliant idea.
I just want to know how they figured this out.
Well, it's called work.
Yeah, but
and it's called being clever and
like, do you think like one guy just went to every location and then they just pop it in there? I mean, how
all right,
do you figure
put
it
this
out?
In. I made a right, a left,
right.
I don't think so.
Obviously, but how do they figure that out?
Oh, Opie, it's done with satellites and mirrors.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Because if you haven't done this yet, just put the address of where you work and your home address.
Yeah,
and you'll be amazed.
It's your way home.
It's like, how do they know that's the way I go home?
You might even find a quicker way home.
True.
Try MapQuest.com.
All right, I believe we'll be talking to Collective Soul next time we take a little break here, all right?
All right.
Stick around. Those guys playing the Bowery Ballroom tonight.
Just giving you a hard time. You know, it's your past life and your attorney. You know, I got to give you a hard time now.
1027 WNAW, the Rock of New York. Two for Tuesday with Van Halen, Top Jimmy, and Jamie's crying. It's Opie and Anthony.
Hey.
And we got a couple of guys from Collective Soul in the studio.
I see.
We got Ed and Ross.
What's up, guys?
Hello.
They've been hanging out in the lobby for the last 20 minutes because I thought the whole band was coming in, and we realized we got two out of the four. That's not bad.
Well, we don't like each other, so, you know, it's...
That's the way rumors get started.
Good. What are the other two guys doing?
I hope beating each other up. That's what they need to be doing.
Oh, man. Yeah.
I don't know. Probably sleeping. We were just going over that. We get shifts. We get to sleep in shifts when you come to New York, this, you know.
Why is that?
The record company works you hard.
Oh, true, huh? Still?
Yeah, there's all kind of press you have to do, and foreign press, it's...
Really?
It's good. It's a good thing.
I was going to say that there's a lot of bands that would kill to be in your
situation. Oh, no.
Right now.
I'm over here whining.
Hey, if the headphones clip out on you, don't mind. We have some equipment problems today.
Yeah, I'm fine.
I just noticed they clipped out again on me.
Yeah.
Isn't this great?
You're still on the air. That you just won't hear it in the headphones. Professional radio station here.
At its best.
Exactly. But you guys are from Stockbridge, Georgia.
Mm-hmm.
I remember that because I had to intro you guys like... Let me think. 5 years ago now, I think?
Yeah, right at the very end. Yeah.
When you guys were first starting out, they played a restaurant on Long Island.
A restaurant.
The Jukebox Cafe. It was like a restaurant. And then we, like, cleared the tables away.
In a corner.
And then played. And then Collective Soul played. And they were moshing and stuff. And the owner of the club was just freaking out.
Cause, Bucky?
Yeah, because people were breaking stuff, man. They didn't realize, you know, how cool Collective Soul was.
And nobody could see anybody because there was no stage. So we're, like, the same level as everybody else.
Yeah.
It's just like a crowd with music coming out of the middle.
We were actually looking up at the audience because I'm kind of short myself.
So you guys have come a long way from then.
Oh, man.
I don't know. We'd still do it in a heartbeat. That's cool. That's great.
And you had dinner with us and our listeners. It was pretty wild back then. But I remember your people, they were yelling at me, don't forget to tell everyone they're from Stockbridge, Georgia.
Really?
Not Georgia, Stockbridge, Georgia.
Who yelled at you from our side?
I don't know. It was either like a record geek or, you know, one of the guys.
Problem here.
No, I don't know. It was one of your people. Where the hell is Stockbridge, Georgia? Because
it's south of Atlanta.
Right.
And I think, I don't know why we kept saying Stockbridge. I have no idea. Well, actually, that's where we're from. But it's just a suburb of Atlanta. It's easy to say Atlanta.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, 15 minutes, you're in Atlanta from where we live.
Mm-hmm. Is that anywhere near Buckhead?
Yes, it is.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
We spent some time in Atlanta.
Really? In Buckhead?
Yeah. Well, we got, just to quickly explain, we got fired from our last radio job, and it was between Atlanta and New York.
Yeah,
and we chose New York over.
We were going to go to Atlanta, so they flew us down there and showed us a good time and stuff. We had fun.
I know where they took you.
Where?
I know where they took you.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. We went there.
Oh, this is some of the
cheetah.
I'm not. We know where you went.
We hit every strip club in Atlanta.
Yeah.
That's a lot of them. How long were you there? A couple of weeks?
yeah, really.
Seriously.
We were doing like about four or five a night. I mean, we just took the tour. You know, the high-class ones, the cheesy ones, and everything.
Yeah, we noticed the different tastes in the bars down there.
Yeah.
You know, there's the real classy one where the girls look nice. Yeah, they're like, don't touch now, don't touch. You know, they have an agent you have to hand the money to, you know. He takes his percentage, gives it to the girl. And then there's the ones that are just like, she just picked up my beer bottle with no hands. You know? I like those places. I like those places best.
Strip clubs and waffle houses in Atlanta.
That's it. On every corner.
Now, do you guys ever run into Elton John when you're in Atlanta?
Yeah, actually, he did a... It's like an acoustic performance at the Fox Theater there and invited us, and we went there and saw that, which was great, you know, just him and the piano.
Mm-hmm.
And he keeps in touch with us, and we keep in touch with him. He's very, very, he's very good to this band.
Keep in touch?
Yeah, I mean, we'll call
him. Oh, I get it, Opie. He's making a joke.
I'm sorry.
Like he touches you.
I'm sorry.
Oh,
I just had to come on. Oh, let's all be shocked.
Oh, my God.
We know he's a good guy.
Where's the cough button?
Yeah.
Ed wants out already.
I get it.
Ross isn't saying much.
He's been very, very supportive of our band. We really appreciate everything he's done for us.
Pretty good music scene in Atlanta these days.
It's great. Great urban scene. It's the cool thing about Atlanta, it's very diverse.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, you know, it really had no history. It's making its own history right now, which is kind of cool. So it's like I said, very diverse. Great urban scene, great hip-hop, you know. And then
especially
you
during Freaknik.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, people got to release energies, you know. I do the same thing, just somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you got the Black Crowes, you got REM, Indigo Girls. It's just I think it's a great scene.
Now, what do you think of the music scene in general? As far as rock goes.
I think it's great. I think it's, you know, people always talk about that it's dead or whatever. I don't think it is. I think things go in cycle. I think, you know, to some people, to the mass majority, it may not be the most exciting form of music right now, but it's not going anywhere. It's going to be here. And, you know, I remember people talking about it in the 80s, and all of a sudden here comes Guns N' Roses, you know.
Right.
They talked about it in the 90s, and all of a sudden here comes Nirvana. So, you know, it just goes in cycles, and it will always be the cornerstone of pop music to me. So, and you know, it just may branch out and get a little bit more different in different areas. But,
right.
It's not going anywhere. I hope
makes
anyway. Our livelihood depends on it.
You guys are doing just fine.
Yeah.
Just fine. You want to play a couple songs for us? Rumor has it you may...
Oh, my goodness. That's what we're waiting on is my acoustic.
Are you?
I'm hoping.
You can just use mine and I'll sing.
No.
Nah.
You go ahead.
I'll watch. I'll listen.
We could just have Ed play by himself.
Oh, no, boy.
What do you want to do?
Where is that call himself. Button? What is going on?
We could take a break and see what happens. How's that?
Mm-hmm. All right. It's your call.
All right, Anthony, the Vermont Teddy Bear Company's Easter is this Sunday. Do something different this year and send your loved ones an Easter bunny or a bear gram from the Vermont Teddy Bear Company. It's a great way to send a surprise that's truly personal and fun, Ant.
What are you going to do, send the same little chocolate Easter bunny for the sweetie to bite the head off of? You could send a Vermont Teddy Bear.
Or those peeps.
Beeps. Peeps.
I like the peeps, but...
I do like peeps, man.
But you got to do something different than the peeps. Maybe get a Vermont Teddy Bear and a peep.
Yeah.
You know?
I hooked up with some peeps this weekend. My sister had them over the house, first peeps of the year.
Mm-hmm.
God, they're great.
What color? Pink?
No, the yellow ones.
Oh, the basic yellow?
Yeah.
I go with the pink.
Bite the heads off of those.
Yeah. All right, so if you're thinking of doing something different for Easter, this Easter Bunny and Bear Graham thing for the Vermont Teddy Bear Company sounds like a great idea. You'll get the bear counselor on the line. Sorry, I'm still thinking about peeps. 1-800-829-BEAR, and you can either order the Easter Bunny, Bear Graham, or maybe something else. They got the chocolate lover bear, the spring fling bunny, or the Easter bear wearing bunny ears, Anthony.
How cute.
That would be cool. I think I think my girlfriend would like that.
Girls love this.
You think Jen would enjoy something like that?
Of course she would.
Oh, how cute.
Yeah. You know.
We gave our chicks bears, and they just freaked out. It really is a great gift. It's different. And the Vermont Teddy Bear Company has hundreds of bears to choose from. So if none of these bears excite you or float your boat, well, you get on the phone with the bear counselor, you tell them a little bit about your lady, and they'll suggest some bears for you.
Yes. A Passover bear? Am I looking at that? Get well, new baby, and Passover.
Wow, that's different.
Look at that.
Every time these guys,
Oy vey.
Every time these guys advertise on our show, they add more and more bears.
More bears.
A very aggressive company, the Vermont Teddy Bear Company. Give them a call. Anthony, men's hair now.
Men's hair now. Let me tell you, seeing is believing.
Yes.
That's the saying.
Yes.
We finally saw one of the clients from Men's Hair Now today.
Well, let's be honest. Yesterday we did a live read for Men's Hair Now, and they sounded great. You know, what they told us, they showed us some pictures and stuff. We're like, okay, you guys seem pretty cool. But we didn't see any of the people live.
Mm-hmm.
So we had to see for ourselves.
Yes.
Listen how much more excited we are today. Because they brought in this guy today, and they showed us pictures of him and showed what he, you know, and we saw what he looks like today because he was with us hanging. We couldn't tell the difference.
I'll tell you something. He came in with one of the people in sales down at the bottom of the stairs. We walked past him. I didn't know why he was here.
Yeah, I thought he was just maybe another one of our clients.
Right. I had no idea this was the guy that had the procedure done.
And then they told us, and we're like, yeah, right. And then they showed us the proof. I'm like, wow.
This is amazing.
Yeah.
I thought when they brought somebody in that I would be able to tell that he was wearing something.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because most of the things that are available to bald guys look like hair hats.
Yeah.
They look awful.
Looks like you got a Barbie doll head.
Right. So I'm saying, all right, I got to see this. They brought in a guy today. Unbelievable.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot tell. He was sitting how far away from us? 2 feet.
Yeah, two feet.
Not even. I stood up to look at his hairline. He had a natural hairline. Was he wearing bangs, Opie? Was he wearing hair that was in front of his face? No.
No,
he had his hair pulled back, and he had a hairline, a natural hairline.
And we asked him a million questions. He said he could swim, he could sweat, he could work out, anything. He doesn't care if it's raining outside. He doesn't need an umbrella or a hat if he wants to get his hair wet. He can.
I still want proof that he is a Men's Hair Now client. It looked that good.
Yeah, and we did see the picture, so we know the guy's for real. But we honestly, you could hear the excitement in our voice. We were amazed. So you can call Men's Hair Now at 1-800-HAIR-202. That's 1-800-HAIR-202 for Men's Hair Now. Try on Men's Hair Now's Hair System 2000, and if you like the way you look, sign up on the spot, and Men's Hair Now will offer you a 50% discount off their regular prices, Anthony. Now, that's an offer you can't refuse.
Appearance, very important these days, whether with women or success in your job. You want to look your best, and with Men's Hair Now, if you're going bald, this is the way to go. It looks great. We saw it today firsthand.
Offer good for 2 weeks only, now through April 9th. Certain restrictions apply. Call 1-800-HAIR-202. That's 1-800-HAIR-202, or go to menshair.com. All right, it's Opie and Anthony. We got to thank Ed and Ross from Collective Soul for stopping on by. Very cool and down to earth guys. That's what we like to see in our rock stars today.
Yeah.
You know, it's always hit or miss when a band comes in here. You know, a lot of them are full of you know what.
They got the tood. You know, the rock tood coming on in. Yeah, man. No, these guys are cool, man.
But I met them in the beginning when they were just starting out, and you know what? 5 years later, they're exactly the same.
That's cool.
They're humble. They're nice. They'll do anything for the radio station that supports them.
Very good.
Unfortunately, the show is sold out tonight at the Bowery Ballroom, but if you got tickets, enjoy.
Have fun.
Now, I know we got to play music here, but another one of our buddies is checking in. We got to say hi to him real fast.
Who's this?
Wayne Krabet.
Hello.
Wayne. From the Jets.
How are you?
You blew us off.
What?
We had this lovely relationship going. You guys were heading toward the Super Bowl, and then all of a sudden, what happened to Wayne?
Are we live?
Yeah.
Oh, you guys dissed me, man.
What do you mean we dissed you?
How did we diss you?
We love you.
We would never diss you. Falling down.
Huh?
Falling down.
Falling down in Denver.
Wait a minute. Who said that?
What did we say?
I forget which one of you said it. It was a while ago, but ragging on me, one of the worst games of my life.
Wait a minute. I defy anybody.
I could almost...
So that's
almost
what,
word for word.
Wait, so that's
and
why...
And Wayne Trebet falls down.
Opie, why did you say that about Wayne?
On that one play you fell down, I said it wasn't your fault.
Well, it kind of was my fault, but...
Oh, well, see, I was defending you, though. Come on.
Wayne, remember, it was Opie. If you want to kick his ass, feel free. I'll watch.
I don't know. One day best friends, next day you're in
Wait
the
Wait a minute. House. Yeah, so that's why you haven't talked to us in 3 months?
No, I've been away.
We had a Bronco bashing party for you guys and everything.
That scared the hell out of me when you guys did that.
Did you hear that on the radio?
That was sick.
No, someone told me about it though.
It was crazy.
It was nuts. They were flipping the Bronco and pulling pieces off it. It was a great promotion. We got like a front page picture on the Jersey paper.
No kidding. Which one?
Which one was it? I forget now.
The Ledger.
What's the other one?
It was the other one.
I forgot.
No matter.
Whatever.
So what are you doing?
Guys are doing pretty well, huh?
Yeah, we're working on it.
The boys still listening to the show a little bit or what?
Well, mostly they pipe in WFAN, but
well, they gotta.
You gotta listen to Mike and the Mad Dog.
No, oh, Jesus.
Wayne Krabet on the phone.
No.
How are things going, Wayne?
Don't even go there. I have a Walkman. It gets a little noisy. And right now, we're just been lifting weights and strength and conditioning and whatnot.
Well, yeah, getting ready.
I mean, come on, you guys had a great year.
Oh, you know, no regrets there. I mean, I think we still could have beat Denver if everyone was on the game.
Well, yeah, that was a frustrating game, to be honest with you.
Yeah, and it was, for a lot of us, it was the first time. And, I mean, we've got a lot of publicity and a lot of hype and a lot of things were expected. But we're going to come back stronger next year.
Right.
Yeah, those Denver fans, what a bunch of assholes.
Yeah, what did they do to your sister? Well, there was a big story. I forgot now because it's been 3 months. Didn't someone, like, spit on her? Or what did they do?
No, they said some really unkind things in the paper out there. And... someone did spit at her, but...
But didn't you get in a fight with a fan or something?
No.
What was the story then? I forgot.
It was something about... I read something that his sister got pushed or something.
The media out there is... it's pretty rough out there.
Yeah.
I don't know what they said or what have you, but...
Colorado. What do you expect?
Bunch of
mutants.
A bunch of rednecks out there.
They get there with their stupid bucktooth Elway jerk-off. God, did you hate just looking at that guy with those teeth?
I don't know. Since I was a kid, I've been watching him, so I really can't stand him. But
And they're all just kissing his ass. Could be the last appearance of Elway here, mile high. Shut up. Who cares about that guy?
Next year, though. That's
really? Get him out of there.
Yeah.
So you guys are making some good deals on the side here during the off season, huh?
Yeah, we're doing okay. My job security increased a little bit with the dismissal of Alex Van Dyke. And I'll tell you one thing, though. After I slipped in the field there, I wasn't too sure for a while. But,
Wait, I got to ask you, because it happens to a lot of athletes. How many times have you run that play in your head at night?
Well, listening to WFAN and you guys.
Come on.
The first couple of days was kind of rough.
Oh, come on.
But
God, that's terrible, man.
You know, I keep thinking, there are a lot of times, like, there are a lot of what ifs.
Right,
but
yeah.
But I had a good season. I mean.
You did, man.
Yeah, and me and a few of the guys, we went down to watch the Super Bowl and watch the Pro Bowl and get the feeling as if, what if we were there and what could we have done?
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, we had a good time, but we're getting pumped up for this year.
Yeah, oh, that sucks though. It's kind of like watching some guy doing your girlfriend. You know, you're watching the Super Bowl. You're like, that should be me. Come on, damn. If only I got her flowers more often.
Yeah, there's a lot of what ifs, but yeah, I think overall, I mean, except for a few plays, it could have gone either way. You know, we could have pulled it out. Yeah.
How'd the toonie treat you after the game?
I'm sorry?
Had the tuna treat you after the game?
No problems at all.
Yeah?
I mean, I think the only thing that he had made strong recommendations to me personally was he wants to see me wearing gloves and especially in the cold weather, long sleeve shirts. He made it very clear to me.
Yeah, your arms get slippery, don't they?
I don't know. I've never had a problem in the past, but he seems to think that, you know, it's his team.
I mean, you turn to him and say, I'd like to see you eating celery.
No, I mean, I've never had a problem in the past, but some strong encouragement to...
Man, don't be hard on yourself. You had a great year. The team had a great year.
No, it felt good, except, you know, I was under the weather just before the Denver game.
Yeah, I remember, because we had you on the air.
Yeah.
But, God, I'm kind of bummed that you heard us say that you fell down.
No, I couldn't believe it got slammed. It was just it was in the car.
Yeah.
And
was that awful?
My people are just letting me down.
Oh, wait a minute. Can we make it up to you? We throw these, like, naked chick parties now. We'll invite you down for one.
There is no way I'm going to that place to be spanked or...
just be trouble.
No. No way in the world.
Obviously, he's got a girlfriend.
No comment.
I don't know. Maybe you were listening to Mike, though. Mike and the Mad Dog.
Yeah.
Maybe that was it.
I can't stand Mike and the Mad Dog. I listen to the fellas in the morning, but they make me too nervous. They just...
they're always, like, critiquing everything.
I think if Wayne would tie his shoelaces a little different, that might help his game. Right, Mikey?
The dog makes me nuts. And you guys do a great imitation. Who does the imitations there?
Well, I started out with the Mad Dog impersonation, and everyone thought I did a pretty good job. It's the only impression I could do. And then Anthony takes it and makes it even better. I hate him.
I had a wasted youth of much too much television, so I just started imitating everything.
You guys used to do TV?
I'm like a retarded minor bird. No, I watched too much television. Is what I did TV for many years.
Hey, how's Yoshi been?
Hey, Paul! Hi, why you are? You ask about me. I love the game of football. Very good. Football look like big pork roast.
That was great. We were out in the car when I listened to that. We just had a ball.
Yeah. So what are you doing in the off season? Anything fun?
Doing a lot of working out.
Yeah.
Like I said, in the off season, we went to Hawaii and
nice.
Checked out the Pro Bowl, and that was a fantastic Verde Street.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And just enjoyed myself. It was to get some sunshine and fresh air and clear my head.
Right.
And spent some time down in Florida.
Mm-hmm.
Spent time with my folks, and now I'm back home and just staying in shape.
Yeah, give our condolences to Vinny's family, man.
Yeah.
That blew.
It was it was kind of upsetting, but I don't know. I think everyone handled it really well.
Right.
Vinny's got a strong family, and, you know, at least the family is finally back at home again with Vinny back in town.
Right. Cool.
So he's got his head, you know, everything's in perspective.
Right. Well, when are you coming down to visit with us?
Well, as long as you guys behave yourself.
All right. If we guarantee there'll be no naked women around, can
no
you come down?
No spankings. No
spanking.
Well, are you allowed to come down and watch someone else get spanked?
I don't want to get...
You know you want to check this out. Who are you kidding?
I could go to your website if I want to check it out. You guys are too dangerous there, and I like you locked in there with...
Well, how about if we lock you in another studio that's adjacent, and you won't be able to touch the girls?
How about if I, like, if across the street in the next building?
Binoculars. Come on. We want you down here for one of these parties.
For what? Well, We'll talk about it another time.
You'll
that girl in the black there looks kind of rough.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Spike.
Spike.
Spike is a tough broad there.
Yeah, she's our hardcore champion, we call her.
But that blonde looks pretty hot, though.
Which one, Tara?
Yeah, the first one, yeah.
Yeah, Tara's pretty hot. We like her.
Yeah, yeah. I told a friend of mine out in California to check into your website there, and he really got a kick out of that.
Oh, cool. Yeah. Well, we're finding someone to take on Tara as the hottest girl to ever appear naked on the show.
How's the search going?
Well, we got four contestants on the website right now. Make sure you vote.
All right, sure.
It's tough to get on because the site's getting pounded. We're getting like 50,000 hits a day right now.
Hey, a bone to pick with you guys. I wrote you a note email and you never sent back.
Well, we're getting
because I couldn't get through on the on that deadline that I had until Rick paged me with this new one.
Well, we'll give you the private line.
I think I have it now, I guess.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It's really
tough.
Email.
It's tough to get to all the email, to be honest with you. We're still reading email that came in 3 months ago. You know, but we're trying to read all of it.
Yeah. Well, I guess popularity goes to some people's heads.
Well, it's...
There you go.
Yeah, man.
Where are you guys going to be broadcasting next year from?
Well, shut up. We're going to try to keep this job.
What was that bit about the mayor of Boston dying?
Yeah.
You know too much about us.
No, I was listening to you on the way home last night.
Oh, yeah. Last night? Yeah, it's a year ago that we got fired.
April Fool's gag.
Oh, man.
Kind of went awry.
That must have got him real big.
Well.
Oof. Man. Talk about falling on the field.
We fell flat on our faces.
We fell on our faces.
No padding, huh?
We were not picked up for the next season.
No. They really threw you out of Boston for that?
Oh, they wanted our heads. They tried to sue us. They tried everything. We were being followed by camera crews for 2 weeks straight.
You kidding me?
We couldn't go into a restaurant, a mall, nothing.
We were hoping something happened that week in the news that would have bumped it out, but it was the most boring news week ever. Oh. So for the whole week, they just, two DJs say the mayor's dead. And it just didn't stop.
Wayne, they set up a live shot on my front lawn.
Get out.
So I'm watching the news, and I'm like, wait a minute, that's a shot from my freaking house. And I look outside, there's the reporter.
It was ridiculous.
I don't know. We've got new security at the complex as of last year, and they're pretty good. Old Harry was getting on in years, and I mean, he's been there since I was like in grammar school or something.
Really?
Before I was born, I don't know.
Yeah.
But, you know, things are a little better there, and if you don't want to talk to someone, you don't have to.
Right. Oh, yeah.
But,
No, when we got fired, like the company that we were with, they didn't even want to know us anymore, so now we had no one to protect us. It was scary. It was scary. So.
Well, where are you going next year?
Well, we're
going to shut up this April 1st,
yeah,
believe me.
Supposedly they're going
to... I don't buy that. What do you guys plan?
No, supposedly they're going to, like, they're thinking of giving us the day off. They don't trust us.
Yeah. I don't trust you.
So we'll just come back. We'll come back on April 2nd and say that Giuliani's a transvestite.
No, we want to keep this job now that we're building an audience. For a while there, we thought we didn't want to keep this job. But
Giuliani doesn't have enough hair to be a transvestite.
Beluga whale. Head.
Oh, man.
Did you hear our show when we came up with 500 nicknames for Giuliani's head?
No.
Oh, that was a great show.
Yeah, pretty fun.
That was great.
500 nicknames?
Yeah, Simon Bar Sinister was my fave.
Oh.
He looks like he's wearing a football helmet without the face guard. Doesn't he? And a little tuft of hair.
He's rough, man. I've seen this kid on TV.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, so we're up to it, guys.
All right, well, we'll let you go.
Okay. Was this the whole thing on the air?
Oh, yeah. This is what we do.
We're on the air.
Okay.
We used to be a lot more careful.
Yeah. Our whole life is on the air.
These days, we really don't care.
No.
So, let me say a little to my family, and I doubt they're listening, but...
Go ahead, man.
Hey, Mom, Dad, wish you the best, and I'll see you real soon.
Okay.
And you fellas, take care and stay in touch, okay?
No, well, Wayne, man, you know, don't be down on us.
No, not down at all.
Because we thought we had made a connection with you, and we were kind of bummed when you didn't check in for like 3 months.
No, I was out of town.
And we apologize that you heard that. That you heard that. He's not apologizing about saying it.
I just had to reset the dials, you know, the radio station.
Oh, look at you. Come on.
That's all I had to do.
And you will be coming down here the next wild party we throw. We'll make sure you're in no pictures and you won't touch the ladies.
Oh, no, any handcuffs come on me, someone's going down.
All right.
Hey, fellas, stay cool. Good luck to you, all right?
Take it easy, Wayne. Say hello to the guys.
Bye-bye.
All right, hold on for a sec.
Okay.
Wayne Corbett from the Jets checking in. Very cool.
Good guy, man.
Oh, I can't believe you heard that show.
What are you, crazy?
Yeah, I guess.
I don't remember exactly what you said. If you just reported accurately what happened on the field, that's one thing. But if you started giving him some crap.
I don't think we did, though.
We're going to have to pull the tape.
I think being a huge Jet fan, I was just, you know, I was frustrated like everyone else. But that wasn't a play that made broke the game.
Exactly.
You know?
All right.
All right, Wayne Corbett, everyone. We'll get him in here.
Yeah.
The Rock of New York, 1027 WNEW, Stone Temple Pilots, Sex Type Thing, and Plush. You're hanging with Opie and Anthony.
Oi.
Got to hand it to the faithful listeners for just pounding the website with the four girls on it.
Yeah, yeah.
We have 22,000 votes in thus far for the next challenger for Tara. We're going to announce the winner Friday because the problem is a lot of people still haven't seen the photos, believe it or not, from Friday's party.
I'm hearing it from the people, Opie. They're saying that the web server is very slow, having a hard time getting connected to it.
Mm-hmm.
It's just getting pounded.
Yeah.
I noticed it's a lot easier to get on after we leave.
Exactly.
So at night.
That's what I was going to suggest.
Yeah.
I mean, right now, it's almost impossible. But after we get off the air or late tonight...
You know, when we're done with our show and the emphasis is on music, maybe you could hit the website and then you could get something, you know. You could get through, I'm sure.
So wait for the wife to go to bed and then punch up the pictures tonight.
Right.
Late night when you're supposedly doing online banking.
Yeah. Honey, I'm banking.
Right.
Doing that banking. Three in the morning.
But we need all the faithful listeners to get their vote in for the four girls that are on the website right now to see who's going to take on Tara.
Mm-hmm.
And we just upped the ante. It looks like Priceline.com is coming through for us. They're going to give away a trip to the winner of this contest.
That's good.
All right?
That's real good.
It's very good. Because
we'll get some class acts in
here. Well, Tara and a bunch of other people kind of expressed to us they want this contest to stay a little classier than it has been lately, Anthony.
I don't understand. What's the problem?
I don't know.
We kind of had a party atmosphere in here Friday. And
yeah.
Maybe things got a little crazy, but I don't know if the class factor dipped any lower than... Well, okay, it did. But but I think people are appreciating it.
Of course.
Sure, they
Most
are.
Most people enjoyed it.
Yes.
And that'll be cool. So one of the ladies will be winning a trip from Priceline.com.
Great.
Yeah, and then, you know, and then we're just going to keep upping the ante until who knows.
Until we get a supermodel walking through the door.
That'll be cool. All right. I got to say hi to John, the elevator man from Jersey. You guys are the best. Listen every day. Keep up the good work. Just inducted into the Hummer Club 10 minutes ago. Thanks.
Bravo.
Later, guys. We're not hearing from a lot of people getting inducted today.
Well, we haven't talked about it that much.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't mean it's not happening. I think a lot of people are doing it in the privacy of their own home.
You think everyone's been inducted at this point? Is our job done, Anthony? Did we get every guy in the New York area a Hummer at this point?
I don't think so.
Oh,
that would be nice. Our job here is done. We can move on.
I can dream, can I?
Yes.
All right.
I think tomorrow we start our new little thing.
Yeah, we might have to fade out the Tuesday Night Hummer Club if this Wednesday thing, you know, takes off. And
yeah.
Then we'll bring back the Tuesday Night Hummer Club in, you know, in the fall or something. It may be time to rest the Tuesday Night Hummer Club. I don't know.
I don't know either.
We'll see. I know the guys are like, what are you nuts? Hey, Mike.
Hello.
Hey, what do you got?
Hey, I wrote a song about the Hummer Club. I thought you guys might like to hear it.
Ooh.
It's sung to the tune of Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Come on. How are you going to pull this off?
Oh, well, you'll hear it.
From Mary Poppins.
I got to do it without music, though. And super. It's called the Super Tuesday Hummer Club, and that's one word.
Okay.
Okay? And here goes. Don't mind. It's with no music, so here we go.
Uh-oh.
My name's Michael, by the way. I'm from Haverstraw up in Rockland County. Rockland County.
All right, Mikey.
These two guys on the radio, they made up a game. I guess we should be more precise. A club's a better name. And for all to join this club, you have to take a chance. Super Tuesday Hummer Club, it's time to drop your pants. Oh, Super Tuesday Hummer Club, oh, it feels delicious. And they say the juice that comes might really be nutritious. If you practice hard enough, he'll really know what bliss is. Super Tuesday Hummer Club, oh, it feels delicious. Hummed it a little bit, hummed it a lot, hummed it a little bit, hummed it a lot. second verse.
Oh, man.
I got my girl to join in every Tuesday is just fine. We're very loyal members and she likes to take her time. But now I'm getting greedy and I have to let her know that it feels good just like it should. But two for Tuesday's how to go. Oh, super Tuesday Hummer Club. Oh, it feels delicious. And they say the juice that comes might really be nutritious. If you practice hard enough, he'll really know what bliss is. Super Tuesday Hummer Club. Oh, it feels delicious. Hummed it a little bit, hummed it a lot. Third verse.
No.
Oh, that's the best one. You got your name in it.
You got to leave on an up.
These guys, Opie and Anthony, they really are extreme. I'm glad that they made up this club. Just go guys can cream. But now they have to come up with a club just for the girls. The Monday munch a bunch of bush. Hey, let's give that a whirl. Okay, that's it.
I think you should have stopped after the first verse.
Okay.
No, let's
great
hear
job,
from Mike.
Bravo.
That was pretty good,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, we'll give you a hand there.
All right.
Very good,
I like
bro.
Your show. You guys are great.
Hey, thanks. We appreciate that.
Thank you very much.
All right, buddy.
Bye.
The vocal stylings.
Of Mike.
Of Mike.
All right. All right, it's Opie and Anthony, and this is kind of interesting. On the phone is Wayne Corbett. Wayne.
Yeah. The real Wayne Corbett.
Now, you don't sound like the Wayne Corbett that was on our show about a half hour ago.
No. That was a forgery. That was a fake. So
this is like What's My Line or something.
It's like a retarded game show or something. Wait a minute. Now, you are Wayne Corbett.
I am Wayne Corbett from Garfield, New Jersey.
You play with the New York Jets.
So,
well, how can we prove that you're the Wayne Corbett and the other guy is an imposter?
Well, the next time the imposter calls, ask him some kind of football question or something he might not know that maybe...
well, he knew.
I don't know. Off the air, I'll give you a tidbit about myself. Maybe he's definitely not going to know.
Well, he knew that there was a security guard at the stadium named, Hank?
Harry.
Harry, or whatever?
But it was common knowledge in the paper that... Yeah. You know, that guy wouldn't let me in when I was a rookie because he thought I was a student still.
What's this guy's motivation, I wonder, then, if he wants to?
Because
he faxed us with some Jets letterhead.
Right.
Also.
Well, my father has Jets letterhead, and he's pretty crazy, too, but he's not faxing yet. But, I mean, I get, like, a lot of fan mail. And, I mean, you know, you get all different types. You know,
right.
I get asked, you know, I get pictures from... You know, Lonely Housewives, you know, any kind of person you want. Send
all right.
Pictures, sending this, sending that. So, you know, there's all different kind of people out there.
So, Wayne, what are you doing on the off season? Let's just run through this again.
What's that? I actually just got back from Jamaica. I did, you know, you remember they used to have the Jeep Eagle Superstars?
Yeah.
Well, I did that this weekend. They're actually airing it this Saturday and Sunday coming up.
If you might remember, the other Wayne Corbett was in Hawaii.
I was in Hawaii for the Pro Bowl.
Oh, okay. Just,
yeah.
Wait.
Well, hey, what do you say about that? Because did he say why he went down?
Well, yeah, he said that he was getting laid a lot. And,
He said he was there for the Pro Bowl, you know, watching. And
because Vinny Testaverde took me down.
Yeah.
So he didn't get that right. He should have got that right, though, because it was in the paper that had asked me.
Wait,
and,
well, if the other Wayne Corbett's listening, you gotta call in now and confess.
What, dueling Corbett's?
Well,
right.
Well, no, but if the guy scammed us, we love when people scam us. We'll admit it.
If you put this on the air, just say, that ain't cool.
Well, no, you're on the air live, dude.
All right, don't do something like that. I don't know what your angle is, but... That's not cool. Don't do that, man. And I work hard to keep a clean-cut image and, you know,
right.
Do the right thing, so I don't need someone trying to ruin it for me.
Well, that's why if indeed he is not the Wayne Corbett and you are, he didn't say anything that would trigger us to think that it wasn't you,
right.
Him, because he wasn't bashing you or anything. It seemed like your persona, you know? Nice
I don't
guy.
Know, man. Maybe he likes me.
Well, maybe he likes you. That's scary.
And that makes it even scarier. Then I really want him to stop. I know there's only one Wayne Corbett in the world.
Well, do you like our radio show?
Yeah, man, you got good stuff. I think you guys are very funny.
Come on.
At least there's a common thread here.
You sure he's not your twin brother or
Nine
something?
Out of ten Wayne Corbett surveyed like the Opie and Anthony show.
I have no brothers. there's another Wayne Corbett in the world. That's my father, but that certainly wasn't him on the phone.
Yeah.
Even though he wants to be me sometimes, that wasn't him. He wouldn't go that far.
Man, this is bizarre.
This is strange.
Because you guys kind of have the same persona, like Anthony was saying.
Yeah.
And he knows a lot about you.
Opie, Joe Willie Namath's on line 2, 4, and 7.
That's the thing. I don't know, man. That's scary.
Yeah, it is.
I said that's real scary.
Well, Wayne, can we make it up to you and, like, have you come in for our next naked girl party?
Wait, hey, you got some naked girl parties going on?
Hey, here's the real Wayne.
It is the real Wayne. If anybody knows me, they know I'll be there. I'll be the first online. I'll hand out tickets, man.
I'm serious. If you want to come down here, we're gonna be doing something soon.
Where are you guys located?
We're in 57th Manhattan.
Cause yeah, I'm calling. I'm listening to the radio station. I'm like, say the damn number so I can call in. And I'm trying to call in for your phone number for information. But,
yeah.
You know what? I'm in the city a lot. I'm gonna drop down one of these days and face to face. You'll match the face with the voice, definitely.
All right, please stop by soon. Because we gotta put an end to this.
Yeah, definitely. If Numbnuts calls back, tell him to go to his other split personality because this one ain't working.
You think he's using your name to get laid and stuff?
Yeah. Hey, man, if it's working for him, I don't go on the radio.
He's going to call next time as Keyshawn.
Hey, I might call as him and give him some bad rap.
Yeah, he might be using your name to go in the gay clubs and stuff.
Oh, come on. That's awful.
Can you imagine? That just has to suck.
I don't even want to think about that, man. All the ladies out there, I'm straight as can be.
There you go.
Any of you, I know, you know that's a fact.
Wayne, we got to make this up to you. We're going to bring you down for our next naked girl party.
All right, man.
I'm serious. And if you're the real Wayne Corbett, we apologize.
Yeah, we apologize.
We have been scared.
Confusion.
I got the number that I called to get in touch with you guys.
Yeah.
What time are you guys on the air from?
3 to 7.
That perfect. Next time I'm in the city, man, I'm calling that number and I'm telling them, buzz me in because I'm coming up.
No, just come in. You're open invite, all right?
I appreciate it, man.
This is unbelievable.
Hey, screen your calls, man. You're ready
to call up. You sound a lot like the other guy, though, I must say, you know.
Oh, man.
How's your off season going?
It's fine. It's fine.
Well, we got all those answers from the other Wayne Corbett, so we don't need to go through it again.
I want to say, how am I doing? Oh, Jesus.
You're doing pretty well.
Yeah. I mean, it sounds like it. This guy's got me down pat.
And he's not even brave enough to call back in to confront you.
He hasn't called back.
So I must say, you have to be the real
thing. He'll probably wait until you hang up and then call up and go, who was that in
Boston? Who is that?
All right, we'll get to the bottom of this before 7. Hey, Wayne, hold on the line for a minute, all right?
I sure will, man.
All right. Line 2 is...
A little controversy here on the Opie and Anthony show.
Line 2 is another Wayne Corbett.
Line 3, Wayne Corbett.
Wait, line 3, Wayne Corbett?
Where's Kitty Carlisle? Hi, N-E-W.
Hi, this is Wayne Corbett. I couldn't resist, guys.
Okay, listen. Ass. So which one do you think was the real Wayne Corbett, the first guy or the second guy?
Number 2, man, number 2.
Yeah, number 2 is obvious, huh?
Yeah.
Now we got to make it up to him and throw him a naked girl party.
Absolutely, guys. You guys are great, man.
Hey, thanks.
Thanks, Wayne.
All right. Hi, N-E-W.
Yeah, hi.
Hi.
How you doing?
All right.
I just want to tell you guys, I think you guys are great. I've been listening to your show for since you guys have been on.
Hey, thanks, man.
And I just got my girlfriend into listening to you guys the last couple of months.
Yeah.
And she loves you guys, too. She loves the Yoshi skit, and I've been telling her about the thing you do with Donald Duck. And all in the family, Archie and Edith.
Right.
If you can play those two skits
so
she can hear them, that would be great. I'd really appreciate it. I listen to you guys all day. I drive for a living, so I'm on the road all day, and I just look forward to 3 o'clock every day to listening to you guys.
That makes our day. Thanks.
Yeah, it's real. You guys are great, and she loves you, too. She loves Yoshi, too.
All right on.
But but she never heard the Edith thing and the Donald Duck thing. You know what I'm talking about.
All right, listen,
about.
You're live on the air. I'm going to hang up with you, and we're going to play a twofer of, you know, Hummer, whatever you call this.
Whatever you just asked
for.
Yeah,
the Donald Duck thing. You know what I'm talking
about.
All right,
we'll
start. With the towel and can I get you a towel?
Yeah. We'll start with the Donald Duck, and we'll do the Edith as soon as I hang up with you.
All right, great. Thank you very much. You guys are great.
Hey, thanks, man.
All right, bye-bye.
All right, for that guy, we'll...
Can you believe this, dude? The first guy totally had me, man.
Yeah, we like when, you know, we get scammed without a doubt.
That's a good job, because he didn't do anything where at the end, you know, there was a Baba Booey or F. Jackie or anything, you
know? Right.
So I figured it was totally legit.
Hey, man, we love a good prank like anyone
sure,
else.
Sure, that's funny, man.
We pulled our prank, so...
I want to hear from that guy.
Yeah, call back the fake Wayne Corbett.